Hi everyone, it's Roseanne. I'm here to do a really quick tutorial for Deb. She asked me to do a tutorial on how I get my images on fabric without having a printer. So this is going to be really quick if I can. Tutorial on how I do that. First of all, you can buy this. I think I bought this a long time ago, so I don't remember where I got it, but I think they have this like at Staples or Office Depot, Office Max stores. You can also get this at Walmart. They have a different brand, but what it's called T-shirt transfers, inkjet T-shirt transfers. And they have inkjets and they also have laser printers at Staples. So you just, when you go, you tell them that they'll see you take this with you. You take your CD of images, if you have your images on a CD or on a, nowadays you don't use CDs. I still do, but I have this little flash drive here, and this has it. It's like a little hard drive, so you plug this into your computer. It's a USB little device. You plug it into your computer, or if you have an adapter, you can plug it into your phone, because this doesn't plug into the phone unless you've got an adapter. Anyway, you put all of your files on this little guy, and then you take this, and you take this, or you buy this there at Office Depot, and you have them print out your images. So then, once you do that, these come with 12 sheets. It's kind of expensive. I've had these forever. I don't use them too often because when I do my images, I try to lay them out and put them on, an 8.5 by 11 piece of paper. But this is what it looks like, this sheet, and then that's the back. Okay, so you take these, and then when you come back, you'll get them all printed. These are all my images that I have gotten printed. When I go, I grab a few, and see, these are the silk ones. This one I've had forever, it's all crumpled, but this is silk paper. It comes in a thing just like this one, but it's silk. It's backed on piece of paper that's 8.5 by 11. Here it is. See, that's this one. It's called Inkjet Silk. Okay, so it's the same thing. They're sheets, but now this sheet has silk on it. I don't know if you'll be able to see in this light. It has silk fabric on the front. Oh, here it is. This is the silk fabric right here. You can see. I don't know if you'll be able to see the texture on that. And then this is the paper backing. So then you would take, if you want to print on these, you would take these to your Office Depot or Staples or whatever. And these come 10, and these are much more expensive. I can't even remember. I bought those so long ago, I don't remember how much they cost. But when you peel the backing off, this is the silk fabric, really pretty, that's on those sheets. Okay, so there's that. And then these, I wonder if I have one that's already printed on silk. Hold on, let me look. I have paper images in here, and I have, oh yeah, see, here we go. See, these are the little silk images. There we go. And See, once it gets printed on a, you know, on a big sheet, then I just cut them down, right? Then I just cut them down. And let me see, bend the little corner here. See if I could get it. Okay, there we go. So see if you can see. Then when you pull it off, see, it comes right off. Oh, I don't know about this camera. There we go. See, it comes right off. And it will end up looking like this type of fabric. So once Staples prints your images on these sheets, then you just bring them home and you, you know, you cut them up or whatever. So now let me show you. These are on fabric, and this is tablecloth. And that's this tablecloth right here that I'm using. So see, what I'll do is I will, now this one I think I took across the street. Yeah, this one isn't a transfer. This one I took across the street and I taped a square piece that was 8.5 by 11 of this fabric onto a piece of printer paper. That's all I did. And I got the double-sided tape and I went all the way across. You know, you have your piece of paper, right? You've got your piece of paper. I just went, I put tape here, 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 and then two or three across. And then you lay your, you'll get your fabric, whatever you're going to use. See, this was a tablecloth that Gail gave me that I'm using for my images. I love the texture. I just love that texture. Then you'll lay your piece of tablecloth on top, right? And, you know, make sure you push it down really well. And then you'll cut around it exactly around the whole piece of paper. That way it's perfectly lined up with the paper and it's, you know, it's taped. You don't want it, you know, bulky in the center. If it's not flat, you want to iron it. Right? Iron your material, your fabric. First, you don't want to iron it on the paper. But iron your fabric. That way it's perfectly flat so that when you go to glue it on there, see, I've already got the straight edge there, how I've been cutting it. So when you go to lay it on there, like so, and you gotta make sure it's all the way to the edge and that it is perfectly lined up. What I do is I just try to, I kind of overlap it a little bit, see? See, it's a little bit overlapped. And then you can always cut it later. Okay. How much time do I have? I have 8 minutes. Okay, so hold on a quick second. Let me just... Sorry for the reach. Let me show you. I have this double-sided tape that I've had 1,000 years. Okay, and then what I try to do... And it doesn't need to be like right on the edge, but pretty darn stinking close as you can get to that edge. Okay. Okay. Can you see that? That little edge right there? That should be okay because you're going to cut. And then, you know, again, you put it all the way down here, down here, down here, and then maybe three across. Or even going this way. Or even, you know, if you want to do it this way. The main thing is you don't, you want to make sure that this fabric that you're going to add to your sheet here, to your sheet of paper, like that. You want to make sure that it's going to be the exact same size. And there's not going to, especially along the top part and the bottom part where you, where you're going to run this paper through, through your printer. Now, this is if you have a printer. If you're going to run this through your printer, that you need to make sure that this edge and this edge, the whatever edge is going, feeding into your printer, that those, these edges right here are perfectly straight, perfectly aligned, and you have to make sure that this fabric is, lays really super flat. I mean, no bumps like that. You can't do that. It'll jam up your printer. It's got to be, that's why I say you need to iron, you know, make sure your fabric is really good and straight and ironed. And if it still has bumps, you can always get a spray bottle and spray your fabric with a little bit of water, dampen it, and then lay it flat. Or if some of you have starch, but I don't really like to use starch because then it makes your fabric stiff. But you could do it that way. So that's how you do it. That's how you print on fabric in your home if you have a printer. But if you don't have a printer, then you would use these, right? You would go to Staples, take those, take your images. Hopefully they're the size that you want on your little drive there. And you just tell them how many you want them. They're going to print on an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. So you want to utilize your 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper and put as many of these images, you know, that you can get. I try to do 9. So I'll do 3, 3, 3 on one 8.5 by 11. See? That's how I line up my images on my computer when I work with the images. I just line them up like this. And then this file gets put in here, and then this gets taken with with these two Staples. Okay, so then you come back, right, and you have, this is the, you know, these are all, this is what Staples will give you. They'll give you the sheet back with all the images printed on it, and then what I did is I just cut them all up. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is I'll show you how I get it on fabric. So, and it's, I mean, it's as simple as ironing. That's all you do. So I have, let me get a little piece of towel there, and I have this, again, this tablecloth, really super pretty. And on this tablecloth, you want to make sure you want to iron on the right side. Okay, so this tablecloth, this is the back side, or the wrong side. It has less texture, and then this side is the good side, or, you know, if it was a printed fabric, which you're not going to iron on printed fabric, but this is the good side. So see, it has all that really cool texture, right? So I'll just lay it down, and I'm just going to, let me grab, I'm so sorry, I keep reaching, I should have had all this prepared. You know me, I'm never prepared. Okay, so I'm just gonna fold this in half here, because I'm gonna take just a little portion of fabric. So I will cut the fabric, and then again, I want to make sure this image is going to go face down on the good side of the fabric. Okay, so I think that's the wrong side. This one is a good side. The other thing you want to do is you want to make sure there's no, see that little lint right there? A little piece of lint. You want to make sure that little piece of lint, there's no, I kind of just hit it against the corner, hit the fabric against the corner of the table or whatever. You want to make sure there's no lint, because when you put this on your fabric and basically turn it over and iron it on, you don't want anything between your image and your fabric, because it could, you know, if it snags or whatever, first of all, it won't adhere correctly. It won't adhere flat. And then you'll have a little bump under your image. The other thing I forgot to tell you is when you take your images to Staples, you want to have them, because you're ironing them on, when you look at the image, it's like this. But when you iron it, it's backwards, right? So see, I don't know if you could see. The image is now flipped over. So if there's words and you have the image, you know, this way and you can read the words, when you flip it over and iron it, the words are going to be backwards. So they need to flip the image if there's words on there, only if there's words on there, so that when you flip it over and iron it, when you look at it this way, you can read the words, because when you iron this, you're going to lift it up and that's what's going to be left. Okay, so we have this, we flipped our images, and I'm just going to, you know, make sure I have this paper centered on my fabric where I want it. I have a little towel here because, I mean, I could probably iron on this cookie sheet, but I want to make sure that there's cush so that I can make sure that this image gets embedded really and ironed on really good on this fabric. So I wonder if it'll fit. Let me see. I'll try to save. I think it just might. So I'm going to do it this way so that maybe I can iron on here. I always save every little scrap of everything. So I'm just going to put the image there. Actually, I'm just going to go ahead and use it because I want to make sure I do it right for you guys. Okay, so just make sure you've got space all the way around on your fabric. That way you're going to have a good image. And then what I do is I turn, this is on low right now, but I turn up my iron. This is my little travel craft iron. I turn it all the way. Oh, I did have it all the way on high. Turn it all the way up on high. And let it, you know, we've been talking, so it's heated up. My little iron is heated up. So, and then just iron. And because this is a travel iron, the handle folds down. It's kind of wonky. So just sit here and iron. Make sure you get all the way across, especially the corners. All these corners need to be ironed really super, super well. Because if they're not ironed down correctly all the way, when you go to lift the paper up, you risk tearing your image. You know, the iron-on isn't going to adhere to the fabric, and then you literally gotta peel the paper off of the fabric. So I just let it sit there for a good, you know, 5 seconds or so, and make sure that your entire image is being ironed on. Okay, cool. So there's that. Now it's hot. Never try to remove your image when this fabric is hot. What I do is, get this and just turn send put it to the side. Okay, now that's on a piece of tablecloth. I also have a piece of a wedding dress satin here. So I am going to just iron some down. Again, make sure that your fabric is always flat and ironed really good. Okay, and then I'm just going to pick up another one of these images. And again, there's no lettering, so I'm just going to lay this down. I'm going to do it up here because I could probably put another image there. So now the satin also, you know, this is the wrong side, right? And this is the pretty side. This is what you want your image on the pretty side. So, pretty side up, image side down. And I don't know why I'm fidgeting so much. I'm just going to do it here, right here. Okay, and then just iron. And you just need a few minutes. And I'm gonna, because I don't want to burn the rest of my satin, I still have, you know, room here for another image. Okay, so there. Now I can, if this burns over here, it doesn't matter. I'm not gonna use that. Again, just make sure all your corners are done. And right now I have the entire image underneath my iron. So it's the whole thing is getting ironed equally. Now, you always need to make sure that the fabric that you're ironing on is going to be able to take the heat, because you do have to have your iron on a really, really high temperature. So, for example, there's no way you could iron on one of these images on organza. You just can't do it. Because it's not going to, you know, the organza is going to just melt underneath your iron. So, okay, so there we go. And see, I missed a little piece right there. But that's okay, because that's not part of the image. That's just part of the edge of the picture. So, it's okay. Right now, it's too hot. Sit it over there. Okay, then the next piece of fabric I want to try is, let me look here. This is another, these are all my fabric scraps. This is another, this is muslin. Or, no, this was, yeah, this is muslin. The muslin is my favorite, but I never have that much muslin. For me, muslin is a luxury. Because I don't get to shop that often. So, I always save my muslin, as when I can. I try to use these other fabrics. So again, this is another type of tablecloth. It's kind of a rayon. It's not cotton. You know, it's got these bumpies on it, which I think this one, whenever I put an image on here, it looks like a canvas. So I really love using this one. So, and then see, I got a little spot here, but I think this area here is going to be good enough for an image. And if this little area down here has a spot, it's okay. You're not really going to see it once you add your image to your project and you frame out your image with your lace and stuff. So see, these ones are ones I already did on silk. All these images are, I had them printed on silk. So, This is gonna, this is, these are all for upcoming projects, all these images. So see, you just bend and peel. Okay, so anyway, let me see, where's my, these are all on silk. There we go. Let's do this one. So this one is on the iron-on. So I'm going to add this. Will it go this way? No, it won't. Okay, so I'm just going to go here and see that little spot. It's just on the bottom there, which it's okay. I don't mind. We're just going to right there. And again, I'm going to iron. Okay, I'm at 25 minutes, so I'm good. And so, if you don't have a printer like me, but guess what? I'm going to get a printer this weekend. Yay! My hubby's friend has an old, he just upgraded his printer, so he's going to give me his little cheapy printer. So at least I'm going to have a printer. I don't know that I'll be able to print my own images. I might try, but I don't know. I'll be able to print images on paper, but I don't know about the fabric thing unless I use these. If I use these, I can run those through the printer with no problem because they're specially made for the printer. But the other method of, you know, taping the fabric to your paper and running it through your printer, I don't think I'd be able to do that with his cheapy printer. But at least that printer is going to hold me for until I can, you know, save my pennies, which I'm doing now, to get a good printer. And there's so many other things I want. Okay, so there we go. It is here on this. See the little spot way down here? You can't even tell on the whole picture. Okay, so then we're going to put this over here and let it cool. These should be cool. Yeah, they are cool. Okay, so that's how you can put your images on several different types of fabrics. Let me unplug my iron, my crafty iron, and get it out of here so I don't burn myself. Okay, and I'm down to just a couple of minutes. Oh, goodness gracious, this is not gonna let me stick this in there. Okay, so I'm gonna bring these over here and I'm gonna move all that over there, and then I'm gonna put my iron over here so it can cool and I'm not touching it. Okay, so there we go. These are all cool to the touch. The paper is cold. You know, all of this one is still a little bit, no, this one is still a little bit warm. That one's cool. Okay, so now all you do is, see, you just push your fabric down, right? That's the corner. You just push your fabric down. And really carefully, don't be too hasty, don't go so fast. Okay, usually it's better on the corner. Once you get your corner started, it should be okay. Then what I like to do is I put my hand here, I just hold the fabric, or the paper, and then I just peel back really slow. Because if you do it this way and you lift up, you risk pulling the image off of the fabric. So I like to just lay it down. And now once I've got a good grip on it, I'll put my finger here and then just peel back. Peel back. And what I try to do is get it across this way so that I can peel the whole image back. And there you go. See? So it's come off the paper. And there's the image. Isn't that gorgeous? And now all you got to do is just, you can fray, which I might do that. You can leave your, you know, your border. I'm going to be using these on my daughter's, on my granddaughter's. I'm making a banner. So I've already got those started. And I will be trying to do a, I'll be trying to do a video on the creation of the banner for my granddaughter. She just got a her bedroom redone in Tiffany blue. So this is just going to be the backing, because I want a pretty backing for the bunting or the banner. And then this is going to be the image. She wanted vintage lady images. And then I'll decorate the front with the touches of Tiffany blue on there. So I'll try to do a video on making the banners. We'll see if that'll be accomplished. But see, now this you can toss away. Now let's look at the wedding dress satin. All right, so here we go. Just pull back. And you want to make sure, see right there? See right there? You want to make sure that, oh, this darn camera. Is it going to focus? Oh, I don't like that. There we go. No, it's not going to focus. Okay. You want to make sure that you, when you pull your paper back, that your image is firmly, see right there? That your image is firmly already on the fabric and not on the paper. And you want to make sure you're not going to pull any up. So once you get it started, so really carefully, okay, so really carefully, just once you get it all started, and you want to pull it back slowly, slowly. As long as it's cooled off, it should be good. And see, this one has some resistance. If it's too tough, okay, I guess it's okay. If you find that you're pulling it off, oh, there we go. Wow, that must be a really old one. It came right off. If you find that it starts pulling up your picture when you're pulling, then just lay this back down and iron it again. Just keep ironing it, and then again, let it cool off before you try to pull the paper.